Hello, PRINTcesses, and welcome back to Not Fit for Print Beauty with me, Rebecca. Today we're here to talk about a brand new product from Victoria Beckham. That is the Victoria Beckham Matte Bronzing Brick. This little guy comes in 5 different shade combinations and is $58. It is currently available on her website, but will probably come out pretty soon. It stores like violet gray. And you could maybe even, sometimes when she originally releases a new makeup product, sometimes you can get it at her boutique too, especially if you're lucky enough to live in London and things are opening back up again. You might be able to see this in person there. Here's hoping. With 5 shade choices, it can be a bit tricky. I will let you know that I chose shade 2, which surprised me. I am a very light medium, and I'm usually right down the middle. For instance, we're going to compare it to Wayne Goss and Patrick Ta in a moment, but they had 3 shade choices, kind of very fair, in somewhere in the middle, and then very, very deep. And I, of course, was somewhere in the middle. And with this, 1 through 5, I was more on the lighter side. So I was a shade 2, which I believe is a Victoria Beckham shade. Wouldn't you know? And then they get deeper and darker from there. But as a light medium, I was number 2. And my little surprise here is that I am wearing it already. We're going to do the demonstration in just a moment. But I am very pleased with it. It's a very subtle, finely milled powder. Very, very, very pretty. But like I said, $58, which is very pricey. So again, as I said, this is called the Matte Bronzing Brick. There is no shimmer or glimmer in either of these shades. So I'll let you take a look here. This again is the shade combination called number 2. And as you see, we have a slightly darker shade that's more for contouring and a slightly lighter shade that is more for a brightening and kind of a bronzing. Now this in a way is, and we're gonna compare it to some others in a moment, in a way this is like almost a contouring palette. I'll show you when I compare it to the other two, it's a bit warmer in both shades, including the contour shade. Usually contours are a little bit gray and cooler to accentuate the shadowy kind of hollows underneath the cheekbones. This is warmer all around, so it is a slightly different look, which is kind of interesting. First, now that you've seen it in the pan, I want to go to just looking at this in a close-up arm swatch. So let me show that to you right now. And you can see right away that even the darker of the two shades, which would be more of the contouring shade, is warmer. On the warmer side, you'll see that especially when we compare it to the other palettes we're going to look at today. So it is definitely kind of a warmer, very summer. You can also mix these two shades together and just kind of bronze all over the face. So you can just go ahead and bronze with it if you're not into contouring. And I've been contouring a lot more lately because we have so many new contour palettes coming out. But if I am just running out the door, to be honest, I just like to bronze up. And this will work for that too. With both shades having a little bit of warmth to it, especially in this shade combination, you can kind of combine, you can do that with all of the shades, all 5 actually. You can run your brush over and just warm your complexion up, whether you are fair to deep. You can warm it up for summer and spring, and it's kind of an instant tan, which is actually really nice, especially because someone like me, and I hope all of you, stays out of the sun. This is a little bit of sunshine that you can add to your face. I want to compare it to 2 others. So if we start comparing bronzers, PRINTcesses, not only will we be here all night, we'll also be a little bit off topic. I get comparing bronzers, and I'm so happy to do it for you over on Instagram. If you have a comparison that you would like, you just let me know and I will make sure to get it up there for you ASAP. But I don't want to confuse contouring and bronzing. Though this palette kind of does a little bit of both, I thought we would be best to just kind of stick to one topic and compare it to some of the most recent contour and bronzing palettes out there, namely Patrick Ta, who has a cream contour and a powder bronzer in one palette, and Wayne Goss's Radiance Boosting Face Palette, which is 2 finely milled powders, much more akin to this, but with a much cooler contouring shade. So let's look at that right now. First of all, let's talk prices. Okay, so the Matte Bronzing Brick by Victoria Beckham is a very hefty $58. Wayne Goss weighs in with 5, okay? So Wayne Goss is $45. This is still available on Beautylish, and all of these are linked below. And I want you to just, this is Wayne Goss, and this is Victoria Beckham. This is Wayne Goss in the medium of the shades, and they were both bought for me, so you can see there is a little bit of a difference. Look at how cool, if my finger is reaching it there, here it is there. Look at how cool the contour shade is. As compared to the very, pardon me as I cough with all the powder in the air, compared to the warmth of the contour shade in Victoria Beckham. I think you'll see that right away. Powder and powder, and this is $45 and this is $58. We are going to see shade comparisons on the arm and talk about the differences as well, so don't worry. Let's look at Patrick Ta, who also has three color shade choices, shade combo choices. So I went with the middle. It still corresponds to the Victoria Beckham number 2 since they were all bought for my face. So let's hold those up together. And I'll tell you that Patrick Ta is the most affordable of our choices today, weighing in at $38. So American dollars, $38. Here, I'll let that center in, is Patrick Ta. Now he does, down below here, a cream contour and a powder bronzer. So we have cream and contour, but as you can see, also much cooler in the contour, where Victoria Beckham's shades both lean a bit warm. So that is actually slightly interesting. She likes a little bit of contour in hers, but really she's more interesting in adding that sunshiny bronzing rather than the very stark contour, which is kind of funny because when you think back to the Spice Girls, Victoria Beckham, Posh Spice, had more of the kind of contour poses, didn't she? In her little black Gucci dress, right? Kind of funny. But in this, it goes for a more sunshiny, glowing look. It's a little bit of a different look. What I want to do now is go to an arm swatch. Now that I have cleared my throat from all the bronzing powder that I launched into the air, we are going to go to a arm swatch, and I have labeled them with a lipstick pencil. So you will notice that on the left in this, we have Victoria Beckham, VB, and then Wayne Goss, WG, and then Patrick Ta, PT. Look at that for a minute on screen, if you would, and you will see the shade differences. And we are comparing apples to apples here. Let me keep that up on the screen. We are comparing apples to apples here because all of these work for my complexion, and they were all bought for my complexion and for me, bought by myself. So you really do have a kind of accurate across the board comparison of those three products. Again, I chose those three because they are, first of all, the most current, and because they are a bronzer and a contour combo, though Victoria Beckham goes heavily into the bronzer portion of that. So I want to now come back with no bronzer, anything on my face, and do a little test for you guys. And I want you to take a look at what you think when it's being applied, so you can see my face before and after and see if I look just much more chiseled and sculpted. My ideal look, I guess, that I'm always searching for. So stay right there. Okay, so let's try it out. I've got blush already on, and I've got some highlighter on, and we're going to open this guy up and give it a try. Now, the demonstrations I've seen, Victoria Beckham and the models that she's using do the lighter kind of bronzing shade, and then they contour, and that's kind of out of order to me, and we can make our own rules with makeup. I think we're old enough now, or young enough to be experimental. So I am actually going to go into my comfort zone, which is to contour first and then bronze a little bit over it. Maybe that's the wrong rule to follow, but we're gonna do that. I have a refer number 20 here, and I'm just gonna put some of the contour on there, and I'm gonna suck in my cheeks really hard because I have a little bit of a chubby little face lately. Okay, and then I'm gonna blend it in. That kind of works, doesn't it? Look how chiseled I look. I know, it's like a different person. Okay, I'm just kind of tapping it on and then blending. You can also do the chin to give myself a jawline that I don't have. And up here, just kind of into the hairline. And I like this because it's rather subtle. Okay, now I'm going to use my very, very favorite bronzing brush, which is by Sonia G. And I'm going to go into the lighter shade. I'm just going to kind of bronze over it just to kind of make it a little golden. And as I said, these are actually kind of golden-y shades to begin with. But I like this. You know, before, though this is a first impression, it's not really in a way I kind of put this on my face. Let's go over the nose a little bit. I just kind of stuck it onto my face just in the mirror with some fingers, and I kind of like the look of it. It's very subtle. This might just be, and we'll have to wait to see, but this might just be my favorite of the three, but obviously I'll play with it and I'll let you guys know. But I really do, I'm looking in my own mirror here, really like it, especially with this look, which is just kind of a very everyday, just kind of pretty, but glamorous makeup look. So it's actually quite pretty. And I think this would be lovely in the eyes and the, kind of on the crease of the eyes, as a lot of us like to use bronzer and contour. And these are kind of warmer shades, so they're really inviting for spring and summer. I think it's a really pretty one. I'd love to know your thoughts, especially when you compare it with the Patrick Ta's dual version and Wayne Goss's dual version. And I'd love to hear what you would like to compare it to below. Again, I did not compare to any straight bronzers. I was just doing the bronze and contour. And I'd love to know your thoughts and what you think, and if I did right on the color choice, shade choice, and all that good stuff. So leave your comments below. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. I hope you did. I know I did. And if you haven't already done so, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.